In this video, I want to talk about stationary tools installed in a home shop and in a wood shop, a workshop, whatever you're making. So if you're working on your house and doing a lot of work in a shop, or whether you're building furniture and doing woodworking and that kind of thing, there's different needs you have, and what you decide to install in your shop as far as stationary tools is a personal decision, but I want to give you some tips that I've picked up over the years and try to guide you as far as what tools are best and what are necessary. All right, first and foremost, I think a table saw is arguably the most important stationary tool in a wood shop of any sort. That means whether you're building furniture and doing woodworking, or whether you're working on your house, a table saw is just a must. I have a really old one here. Actually, it was a hand-me-down from my grandfather, and I should probably update it. But I also have a more modern version, and actually I have another one yet. But a table saw allows you to do ripping and to resize wood in all sorts of ways. There's a million types of jigs you can build for it. You can even do cross-cutting with a table saw, although it's not particularly convenient. And having one on wheels or a portable version allows you to move it around. So whether you're building furniture or whether you're working on your house, a table saw is an absolute must. And that really, I think, should be the first tool that you start with. Spend a little bit of money, don't get garbage, because this is a tool you'll use a lot. All right. I think the next thing would be cross cutting. So when you're working with wood, you have to have some means of cross cutting wood, cutting across the grain. One option, and usually pretty cheap, is a radial arm saw, and I have another video about that. And they have disadvantages as well as advantages. And a more modern idea would be to use, a chop saw of some sort. And there's different versions of this as well, different sizes. But some means of cross-cutting wood is pretty important, especially if you're working on your home. If you're doing, crown molding or different types of trim work, definitely this is a saw that you have to have. If you're doing woodworking, there are other ways of cross-cutting, but certainly it's far more convenient to have a stationary tool of some sort like this. My preference, if you're just starting out, would be for some sort of chop saw rather than a radial arm saw. But radial arm saws are very inexpensive on the used market, so that's something to think about too. All right. The jointer is another tool that is frequently on the list, especially of woodworkers. And I have to say, it's a tool that it's very, very useful, especially if you're doing production-oriented work. And mostly what it's used for is to dress the edges of wood when you're joining multiple pieces together. It can be used to flatten or smooth the flat side of a piece of wood, but you're limited by the size of the jointer. This particular one is a 6-inch model, which is a very common model. And quite honestly, I don't think too many people, including myself, use a jointer for flattening wood. Once in a blue moon, but mostly it's used for dressing the edges. So, given the cost of it, it's a fairly expensive tool for what you're getting. And there are certainly other ways to dress the edges of wood, including a hand plane, which is nothing wrong with that. It's still pretty quick. An electric version or a handheld version of a plane. So, it's a good tool to have if you have the money. But if money's tight, I would say hold off on this until you can find another means of dressing the edges of wood. Now, when you're trying to flatten or resize the flat side of wood, the other tool you're going to want is this, which is a planer. This is an older, actually, model that I've had for many years. It's a Delta 12.5-inch planer. And this allows you to feed wood in and flatten it if it's rough, or change the thickness of the wood. And this is an extremely, extremely useful tool. If you're doing woodworking, especially, I think this should be fairly high on your list as far as stationary tools. In fact, I would think this should be a tool you get before a jointer, which goes against a lot of the advice out there, I imagine. But it's just an extremely, extremely useful tool and allows you to do things, especially in woodworking, that you can't do otherwise. So that should be very high on your list. All right, here's a bandsaw. And bandsaws, again, it's fairly expensive for what you're getting, but if you're doing woodworking, especially, this is a tool that has some very useful features. My bandsaw here has an extension in the back here, which allows me to do resawing because it extends, so this head can come all the way up here. And I can take literally just logs of firewood and put them through here because of the amount of space I have. And you can even take existing wood that's already been, you know, sawn or cut to size and resaw it. So that's a very handy feature to have. And it's not that much more money if you're getting a bandsaw to get the extension. So I would recommend doing that. And a bandsaw obviously allows you to cut curves and to do, you know, safely to do some cutting that would be difficult on other tools. So as far as woodworking, I'd say this is fairly high on the list. For, you know, if you're working on your home, you know, you could probably do without it. And just a handheld jigsaw would be a better bet for now, unless you have all sorts of money. But it is a handy tool to have. All right, here's the router table. Mine's a homemade version. I have a nice Bosch router in there. I don't know if you can see that. And of course, routers are a very important part of the modern shop. I literally don't even know how many I have. I think I have 6 or 8 of them. But a router table allows you to do all sorts of things for woodworking and also for working on your home. You know, raised panel doors and you know, more advanced things like that are certainly possible on a router table. But even just making your own moldings or you know, trimming up special pieces of wood that you can't do other ways, at least handheld, a router table is really, really important. And I would say this should be very high on your list, whether you're doing, you know, work on your house or whether you're doing woodworking. So plan on getting a good router, and whether you make a homemade router table like I did or whether you buy a commercial version, that should be very, very high on your list. All right, here's my lathe, my wood lathe. And this is something, if you're working on your house, you really don't need this, unless you want to, but it's not something that's important for a shop if mostly what you're doing is working on your house. But if you're doing woodworking, a lathe is very high on the list again. Whether you're making legs for tables and chairs and that kind of thing, making dowels and special sized pieces of wood for construction, this is a very, very useful tool and a lot of fun as well, and allows you to make furniture that you really can't do otherwise. If you're forced to buy commercial versions of legs for tables and that sort of thing, it's going to look like it. But if you want to do, you know, custom furniture, stuff that looks handmade and looks like you put some effort into it, a lathe is a really, really important feature. And as part of that lathe, you're going to need a bunch of tools to go with it. And one very important part of a lathe is a sharpening center. And this is mine here. A sharpening center is absolutely critical for sharpening the tools that you're going to use on your lathe. But even if you don't have a lathe, a sharpening center is very, very important for you know, your chisels and keeping things sharp. You don't need to necessarily get anything as elaborate as I have here, but having some sort of station where you can sharpen your tools, whether you're working on your house or doing woodworking for furniture and that kind of thing, is very important. All right, here's a tool that it's a specialty tool, and it's not something I would say you need right away. This is basically a drill press that allows me to cut square holes, is what it comes down to. A mortising machine has a round drill bit in the center and a square chisel on the outside. And when I pull down, you know, the handle up here, that allows you to cut mortises from mortise and tenon joinery, but it cuts a square hole. So it's a really nice tool to have, but it's certainly not necessary. And even if woodworking is your main goal, I would say this is a tool that you don't need right away. You can certainly cut mortises other ways with a drill press and a hand chisel on the router table. There's definitely other ways of making mortises, but you know, if you have the money and you're starting to do a lot of woodworking, this is a nice tool to have. A drill press, again, is not super necessary for a lot of things. If you're working on your house, you probably don't need one at all, and you can certainly get away with hand tools. If you're doing woodworking, furniture building, that kind of thing, it is very nice to have. It allows you to have more accuracy than you have with a hand tool, and it allows you to make mortises by cutting multiple holes. So a drill press is nice to have. This is a really old one that I got at an auction for $15 and fixed it up. You know, a newer one's going to cost you more money, but It is a handy tool to have, and if you have access to one, inexpensively get it, but I would say it's not strictly necessary for a lot of work. All right, what about dust collection? I actually have another video showing my dust collection system, but is this something you need? Well, you know, for many, many years, actually more than a decade, I went without dust collection, and it is very, very, very nice to have. You know, you can work without it, but if you're starting to get into more production-oriented work, it really is handy, and health-wise, it's definitely better for you. So this is something that should be fairly high on your list. It's not absolutely necessary, and depending on your setup, I mean, if you have a garage where you can open the doors and that sort of thing, you know, maybe you don't need it right away, but if you have an enclosed area like a basement or something like that, I would say it should be high on your list, and it will make life very much easier for you and more pleasant to work on whatever you're working on. A small compressor is very useful for a lot of woodworking, mostly to run nail guns. You know, a brad nailer or a small, you know, 18 gauge nailer is so critical nowadays for putting up trim, for building small pieces on furniture, and for even for tacking furniture together as you're making it and that kind of thing. And yes, you can use a you know, a regular hammer and nail just like they have for centuries, but frankly, for quality work, a nail gun really is superior than hand nailing in many, many cases. It leaves a much smaller hole, and it allows you to put small pieces together that will be very difficult with a hammer. Not that you can't do it, but it just makes life a lot more pleasant to deal with. So a small compressor like this one, you don't need a giant thing like you would for you know, an automotive shop or something like that, but just something like this to keep in the bottom of the shop and have that air handy. Even for blowing out sawdust of small corners and that sort of thing, it can be handy. So a compressor, I think, should be part of your shop, but it's really not that expensive. There are lots of stationary sanders that you can buy, and that's something I've always considered, but honestly, I've never bought one because with combinations of different hand sanders, and I have a lot more than this, stationary sanders have really been a luxury that I felt like I could do without, and I didn't want to take up the room in my shop. But if you're doing a lot of woodworking and certain types of woodworking, a stationary sander can be helpful, but certainly not necessary. You can use hand sanders of various types to get away with an awful lot. The last thing I'm going to talk about is the shop itself. You know, a lot of people just don't have a lot of room to build a shop, but I have to tell you, after building my own shop here, I used to work in a garage. Having the space, having high ceilings if possible, and having a lot of room to actually work, I mean, you want areas like this that just have nothing in it so you can build whatever you're building. That is really a key feature for any shop. And as you're building your shop with stationary tools, just remember that you're taking up space with each tool. So, you know, money is part of the equation, but the other equation is space in your shop. And you want to leave yourself enough space to work. And sometimes having that extra stationary tool is not quite worth it, considering that you're giving up space to put it in. So that's some of my tips, and good luck building your own shop.